So let's walk through. I'm talking with Dr. Greg here, and he just started his personal injury attorney referral program. And essentially what happened is we did the presentation on a what that was a Thursday night to his group of attorneys. Immediately started the referral process, lined up a couple attorneys to do financial driver analysis to show them what they do or don't have. And turns out right on the spot, he not only got two financial driver analysis to start the referral, but he got a referral on the spot when he went over there. And turns out the attorney didn't have much in the way of documentation. So let's go through how that worked. So Dr. Greg, that was your first that was the first personal injury attorney educational sales seminar Thursday night, right?
Yes, that's correct.
So you've never really pushed personal injury or tried to get referrals from attorneys?
Right.
Okay, so you bring the attorneys there, and this particular one, he signs up for your financial driver case. By the way, how did he like the presentation?
He liked it a lot in a way that, he was following every word.
Okay, so he was very attentive. Would you say that?
Yes.
Okay, and how long had he been in practice, just roughly?
This gentleman's, I would say, over 30 years.
Oh, quite a while.
Yeah,
So you would think he would know what's going on and what's happening in personal injury, right?
right.
Okay. So we offer at the end of the presentation, we get him, we basically the presentation motivates them to refer. So we take the next step and we offer two financial driver case analysis. So you did that, the presentation was Thursday. You did that on Tuesday. So you go over there for the case analysis, and generally speaking, what happened?
So yeah, he was ready and waiting on me, and he wanted to, he had five, about 4 to 5 different cases that he wanted me to look at the documentation for.
So I think it's safe to say he was real interested if he had five cases he wanted you to look at.
Yes.
And you've never talked to an attorney before that presentation, had you?
Right, that's correct.
Did it surprise you how much out of the way he was going to try to get you to help him?
Yeah, it really did, yeah.
Okay. So, of course, you didn't have time to do five, so you start with one. But you said that you not only did that financial driver evaluation, you said he referred you another patient on the spot. Is that right?
That's correct. From one of the cases he had me look at, he sent me that patient.
Okay, so that was so the financial driver case analysis that you did when you showed him what was missing, that was the case he referred to you, right?
That's correct.
Okay, and you average well how much for a personal injury case, a case average?
I would say 3,000.
3,000. So one presentation, one follow-up meeting, you immediately start the referral process, $3,000 per referral. How's it looking?
Yeah, good.
Okay. So you go through the financial documentation. Did it surprise you? First of all, was he working with chiropractors? Did part of the documentation you looked at was part of it chiropractic?
Yes.
Okay. And when you went through the documentation with him, how much of the documentation that was required to stop low ball offers, how much of it did he actually have?
He probably only had about 10 to 20% of it.
About 20%. And it was easy for you to show him that?
Yes.
Okay. And when you showed him that the chiropractors he was working with or did that case only had about 20% of the documentation necessary to support his injury award, what did he think about that?
Yeah, I think he knew that he didn't have a lot of documentation going for him, and again, he was on board with everything I was showing him.
Was he mad or disappointed that the chiropractor that was working that case pretty much gave him junk?
I would say, yeah, concerned.
And you say he'd been practicing 30 years and he did not even know he had junk, did he?
Correct.
And that's what I keep talking about with these attorneys. They're in a state of unconscious incompetence. They don't even know what they don't know. And they think just because it's a doctor or chiropractor that that automatically means they'll have the right documentation. And that's not the case at all. You found that out, didn't you?
Yeah.
And as a matter of fact, when you went through the notes, you probably found it was he probably had the notes organized by the different providers. But did you see anything at all from the doctors that basically put his case together for him in a narrative report to tie it all together? Or was it just random notes
It
of
was just random. Yeah.
And that's the other thing I keep talking about with doctors. These attorneys have random notes. They don't know how to put it together. They don't know what's missing. And it's a state of unconscious incompetence. And so they don't think they need chiropractors. And if you don't know how to do that presentation, what's the likelihood of you ever getting that referral if you would have not known how to do that presentation to begin with?
Oh, there's no way I would have gotten that. Yeah.
Because he didn't, prior to that presentation, he didn't think there was anything wrong with his notes, did he?
Right.
Yeah. And that's why advertising and publicity does not work, because they don't even know there's a need or there's a problem. And the only way to switch that is what's called educational sales. It's a very, very, very specific formula. And of course, that's what we teach, that's what we did. And so that's what I actually did to open 77 offices in 20 states. So just like that, your personal injury referral started. Your very first presentation, very first meeting with an attorney. Is that right?
That's right, yeah.
And how difficult would you say all that was?
It was actually relatively easy once you just get the courage up to do it.
Right.
It
In
kind of
other words,
falls into place.
the material's not hard, is it?
Right, yeah.
But you do have to learn it though, right?
Right.
Is there any way you could have done that on your own?
No.
Right. And I mean, that material's very specific, isn't it?
Correct, yeah.
Yeah. So here we are. You're off to your referrals. There's a $3,000 check that just happened like that. And we just spent a little bit of money off to do that. All we did is invited him to a continuing legal education dinner, did a little presentation, and there you have it. You're off to the races. So really with him, all you have to do is do all the documentation like you told him you can, and you're pretty much going to be getting all his referrals, aren't you?
Yeah, that's correct. I've already got an appointment with him next week to go over another case.
Another case, yeah. In other words, he doesn't. Can you see now how he does not have an option to send them anywhere else but to you?
Yeah.
Or he will see that he'll lose out on essentially 80% of the necessary documentation for his injury award. Can you now see that?
Yeah.
What was the biggest takeaway, the surprise when you went over and did that? What was the biggest surprise that you got out of that whole interaction and the referral process?
I think the total switch of consciousness, the attorney, comes into the room, as you say, not knowing. And then when you do the presentation and you go through documentation on a case, this the total transformation, the total switch that they're on board, they're hearing every word you say because you're now the authority. So that was the biggest takeaway.
So you saw him come in and with an attitude that he didn't need you.
Yeah.
And then we take him through the presentation. How quickly did you start to see his attitude change that he knew he was in trouble with the documentation that he presently had?
Yeah, very quick, within the first 15, 20 minutes.
It happens pretty fast. And then by the end of the presentation, they're more than willing to get you to look at their case to see what's missing, aren't they?
Right, yep.
Yeah. So you went from being a nobody to the only person he can refer to, and you did that in less than 5 days in one presentation, right?
Right, correct.
Yeah. Pretty empowering, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Yeah. And now you're just going to do that with other attorneys, aren't you? Matter of fact, you have somebody else lined up now also, don't
Yeah,
you?
I have another one lined up next week as well to talk about some cases. Yeah.
So you already got this one going. You got the immediate referral. You set him up again to do another one of his cases next week. Of course, you know, once you do it again, you'll get that referral too, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Because he won't have an option, will he?
No.
And then the whole process starts over with the next attorney, doesn't it?
Right.
See how easy it is to build a chiropractic personal injury practice when you actually know what you're doing?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah. All right. Thanks a lot.